Hi Chintan, welcome to our online class. In our previous class, we discussed the Indian rivers. In this class, we will discuss water use in an area or a region. How is the water is used in that area? This is the topic for today. Water is a free resource. All of you know that. Water is a free resource. By the grace of nature, we get plenty of water without paying any money. That is a free thing. Our first point is water budget and water shares. Before going into discuss this, we have to know what is a budget. All of you know about the budgets of central governments and state governments. What are the budgets? These budgets are called financial budgets. What do these budgets tell us? A budget tells us about the income and expenditure of the governments. Generally, a financial budget tells us about the income and expenditure of the governments. Water budget tells us about the receiving water and used water. How much amount of water is received in that year and how much of water is used in that year. These two things will be told in the water budget. Simply we can say, what is a water budget? We can say the budget which tells about the receiving of water in a year and use of water in a year is called water budget. We have to balance the budget. The receiving and the use both will be same. That is a ideal situation. The second thing is watersheds. Watersheds. What is a watershed? The activities of increasing ground level water, groundwater levels. The activities of increasing groundwater levels is called watersheds. Watersheds. In this program, all the governments, state governments and also central governments, spent more and more money to increase water levels in every part of the country. That is watersheds. Next, water budget deals with inflow and outflow of an area. Inflow and outflow of an area. Inflow means the flow inside. Outflow means the flow outside. Generally, for any area, inflow is equal to precipitation plus surface flow plus groundwater flow. What is the precipitation? Can you say? What is the precipitation? In 9th class, you read about it. The process of changing water into water vapor is called precipitation. All of us know that there is water vapor in the atmosphere. The water vapor in the atmosphere reaches the surface of the earth in various forms. This is called precipitation. What are the forms of precipitation? The forms of precipitation are rainfall, snowfall, dew, fog, sleet, hailstorm, etc. All these are different forms of precipitation. In 9th class, we discussed them in very detailed manner. This is precipitation. Once I'm repeating this, there is water vapor in the atmosphere. The water vapor reaches the earth in various forms. This is called precipitation. The forms of precipitation are rainfall, snowfall, dew, fog, sleet, hailstorm, etc. Generally, rainfall is the most common precipitation in our area. Rainfall is the most common precipitation in our area. We can get water by rainfall. 99% of water we can get through rainfall. In the Himalayan areas and the polar area, polar regions, snowfall is a common precipitation in those areas. The second one is surface flow. Surface flow. Surface flow includes rivers, streams, rivulets, canals, and other flows on the surface. We can get water by rivers. We can get water through streams. We can get water through rivulets. We can get water through canals from the irrigation projects. Canals from the big dams. All these are surface flows. All these are surface flows. We can get water by all these sources. Those are surface flows. Next one is groundwater flow. Groundwater flow. It is difficult to estimate groundwater flow. We cannot see groundwater flow. Actually, it flows in the underground. So, we cannot estimate it. Only we can guess it. Only we can guess it on the basis of slope of that area. On the basis of slope of that area. Once I'm repeating this, inflow is equal to precipitation plus surface flow plus groundwater flow. And the next point is outflow. Outflow of an area and outflow of a region. The first one is evapotranspiration. The first one is evapotranspiration. Evapotranspiration comes from two words. Those are evaporation plus transpiration. Do you know evaporation? Do you know evaporation? Okay. The process of changing water into water vapor is called evaporation. Once I'm repeating this, the process of changing water into water vapor is called evaporation. Evaporation takes place all the time in water bodies. Evaporation takes place from the tanks in our village. Evaporation takes place from the wells in our village. Evaporation takes place from the lakes in our area. Evaporation takes place even in seas and oceans. All the water bodies evaporate some amount of water into atmosphere. That is outflow. That is one form of outflow. The second one is transpiration. Transpiration. Transpiration means living things give off water into atmosphere. Living things like humans, trees, plants, or animals, etc. All the living things give off water into atmosphere through their breathing process. Through their breathing process. This is called transpiration. Once I'm repeating this, living things give off water into atmosphere through their breathing process. This is called transpiration. Non-living things like tanks, ponds, lakes, seas and oceans give off water and atmosphere. The process is called evaporation. Living things give off water and atmosphere through their breathing process. This process is called transpiration. Evaporation plus transpiration is equal to evapotranspiration. What is the evapotranspiration? What is the evapotranspiration? Simply we can say the amount of water added to the atmosphere both from evaporation and transpiration is called evapotranspiration. Once I'm repeating this. The total amount of water added to the atmosphere both from evaporation and transpiration is called evapotranspiration. The next point is water flowing via surface flow and groundwater flow. Water flowing via means through surface flow and groundwater flow. Some amount of water flow out of our villages. Some amount of water flow out of our villages through canals, streams, rivers, etc. During the rainy season, most of the water flow outside the village because there is excess water in our village. That is a surface flow, surface outflow. Next, groundwater. How do we get groundwater? Do you know? A portion of rainwater percolates into ground. That means percolates into soil. This groundwater reaches the water layers underground the earth. Some amount of rainwater goes into water layers. Underground. And this some of this water may be used through wells and tube wells. We can use it for some extent. Some amount of water goes very deep into underground. That cannot be used. Some amount of water flows through streams, rivers, etc. That is a matter about groundwater. Water flowing via surface flow and groundwater flow. Some amount of water flows out of our villages through surface flow, groundwater flow. The third point is water use for agriculture. Water reaches the root zone of crops. Of crops either through rainfall or the process of irrigation. If there is excess of water, it would damage the roots. If there is not sufficient moisture, the crop will be withered. This is also outflow of water. We can lose some water with this process. Water used for domestic purpose and for animals. We use water in different ways. For cooking, for washing clothes, for bathing, for cleaning floor, etc. All these activities require water. All these are household purposes. And so water is also useful to our animals. We use water to wash our animals. In these processes, we use some amount of water. The fifth point is water used for industries. Water used for industries. The manufacturing processes, we use water in industries. Without water, we can't run an industry. Without water, we can't run an industry. There are many uses of water in industries. We have to meet all these needs. We have to meet all these needs. The need of agriculture, the need of house purposes, the need of animals, the need for industries. All these are needs of water. You know, through all these activities, we use some amount of water. These five are the outflows of water of an area or a region. The last point is availability of water. Availability of water. Availability of water in an area or a region is not only depends on rainfall, not only depends on rainfall, but also on the stock of water at that area. Rainfall gives us some amount of water, but in the previous years, some amount of water is stored there in the underground aquifers. Aquifers means water layers. We have to use both of these. We can use rainfall, we can use groundwater. Both are available to us. But in recent years, the groundwater levels are decreasing. The groundwater levels are decreasing very rapidly. This is a dangerous thing to our future. Okay, but some of the lesson. First, we discuss water budget and watersheds. Water budget tells us the receiving of water, the receiving amount of water, and the use of water. Watershed tells us the activities that are useful to increase groundwater levels. Inflow is equal to precipitation plus surface flow plus groundwater flow. Precipitation may be in various forms. Rainfall is the most common precipitation in our area. We get most of the water through rainfall. Surface flow. Because of surface flows, we can get some water. Because of groundwater flow, we can get some water. Next one is outflow. We lose water through these five outflows. The first one is evapotranspiration. Evapotranspiration. The total amount of water added to the atmosphere, both from evaporation and transpiration is called evapotranspiration. Next, water flowing with a surface flow and groundwater flow. Through surface flow and through groundwater flow, we lose some water. That is this point. Water used for agriculture. By cultivating various crops, we lose some amount of water. For use domestic purpose and animals, in our daily activities and to rear our animals, we can lose some amount of water. This is water used for domestic purpose and animals. Water used for industries. In manufacturing processes, we use water in industries. All these are water losing activities. So these are called outflow of the water. Availability of water depends not only on rainfall, but also on stock of the water at that area. We have to increase water tables or water levels in our area. Unfortunately, in the recent years, the water levels are decreasing in many parts of the country. We have to increase them. Okay, thank you.